Mrs. Trapp. Mrs. Trapp spent her 40th birthday brooding in a bubble bath. Life had her completely down. In fact, life was the only thing that had had her down and weak. You see, Mrs. Trapp was what you might call a frustrated nymphomaniac. Her only excuse for living was a harbor home for wayward cats. She was getting damn sick and tired of running a cat house. The only thing that soothed her twanging nerves was laying in her bubble bath, reading her copy of In Bed We Try. And there she stayed until the last bubble burst. Trapp was doubly unhappy because only a month before she had buried her last husband. She was already beginning to suspect the old goat of having popped off on purpose. Never before had she known of any man dying from eating too many oysters. Bitterly she remembered the old days. The young husband, George, her first. So young, so virile, so big. In all the little ways that women love. Earl, her second, so lousy. So lousy with stocks and bonds and so lousy. Her third, whose name escaped her, who had been terrific. He and she had a perfect arrangement. He had his friends and she had his friends. And her last lamented Mr. Trapp, a charming, absent-minded gentleman, 20 years her senior, who once said to her over a tired grapefruit, "Pigeon, pigeon darling, you know that I feel 15 years younger after a good shave in the morning?" And Mrs. Trapp looked him straight in the eye and said, "Why don't you try shaving before you go to bed?" Into alone. Now in the deepening twilight she stared 40 right in the teeth and felt older than Oklahoma. Suddenly she set a bolt right in the tub. Bubbles flew helter-skelter. Was it a dream or did she hear a man cough in her bedroom? For a minute she sat all tense like a circus. And then a polite male voice asked if she'd like to have her sink unplugged. Before Mrs. Trapp could even move, the door opened and there stood 6 solid feet of plumber. Mrs. Trapp took one look and thought, "He looks like a Greek god." And the second look, he looked like a Greek god! The third look, she hoped he was nearsighted. So 3 hours later, when they finally left the bathroom, left it just long enough to get a marriage license and return. She went to her waiting car under an arch of cross plungers. There was a heavy flush on the groom's face, and the bride was sprinkled with toilet water. But Mrs. Trapp didn't give a damn, for she knew at last she'd found her ace in the hole.